This episode of CleaningBiz.tv is made possible by CleaningBizAppointments.com. If you're looking for a way to find targeted leads and appointments for your commercial cleaning business and stay in touch with them without having to do it all yourself, we've found a solution for you. And members of the janitorial store get a special discount when you sign up for the service. I'm Jean Hansen, and this is a show that will help turn your vision into a successful cleaning business. We always talk about building relationships with people in order to build your cleaning business, and we truly believe this is the best way, at least if you're looking for long-term clients. But many people focus most of their time on building relationships in order to gain new clients and then forget about how they're going to build trust and keep that relationship going long-term. So today, I'm going to talk about the five keys to building trust with your clients. Number one, under-promise and over-deliver. Don't just strive for delivering exactly what you say you'll deliver, strive for over-delivering. For example, if a client asks if you can come over sometime in the next week to do some carpet spotting, don't just go a few days later to do the spotting. Sure, that'll make them happy, but if you go over today to take care of it, then you'll probably wow them when they come into work the next day to see the spots are gone. So the key to getting people to trust you in this situation is to do what you said you would do before you said you would do it. Number two, be a problem solver. If a client needs something, respond quickly and find a way to solve their problem. For example, if a client asks a question and you tell her that you'll get back to her by this afternoon with an answer, well then get back to her this afternoon with an answer. Don't string someone along because you don't know how to solve the problem. Now, we used to work with a property manager that would call us up all the time and say, I've got a problem. One day it would be, someone spilled toner on the carpet. And the next day it'd be, we've got a flood in the restroom and our little shop vac can't keep up with it. Do you have any equipment that'll clean all this water up? Even though this property manager had his own maintenance people that were supposed to handle some of the daytime issues that would come up, he would still call us because he knew we were always ready to help resolve any problems that came up in the buildings. Number three, be dependable. If a client calls because he needs a last-minute cleaning, do whatever you can to make sure the job gets done. If you don't prove yourself to be dependable, he'll never trust that you can handle the job, and when that happens, he'll eventually stop asking and find someone else to do it. When you are dependable, they'll consider you trustworthy. Number four, tell the truth. Never lie to your customers. You'll lose their trust and probably lose them as a client. Sometimes people lie, cover up, or even stretch the truth when they find themselves in a sticky situation. This is not the right way to handle your clients because they'll see right through it. If you've done something wrong or made a mistake, own up to it. They may not be happy about it, but you'll earn their respect and probably keep them as a client if you always tell the truth. So here's an example of stretching the truth and how it'll come back to bite you. One of our members shared that a new client wanted him to strip and wax her entryway floor. Now, floor care is a service he really wanted to offer but didn't have any experience yet. So instead of being honest about his lack of experience, he stretched the truth and told the client that he did have plenty of experience and agreed to do the floor. Well, needless to say, the floor didn't turn out well and he had to come clean with his client. Do you think that client was able to place much trust in anything his new cleaning contractor had to say after that? Probably not. Number five, provide excellent service. Now you may think this is a given, but a lot of companies get complacent after a few months or even a few weeks after gaining a new client. Things seem to be going smoothly, so they let up on the follow-up and things start to slide. Hold yourself and your employees to high standards. The less your client has to reach for the phone to call you with a complaint, the more trustworthy you'll become in their eyes. Chances are when they pick up the phone, it will be to ask for your advice in dealing with a problem they've encountered, rather than complaining about the service. Building trust with your clients doesn't happen overnight. It takes time. However, it doesn't take a lot of effort to build trust. It's those little things that can make the difference. replying to their calls immediately, handling last-minute problems, and providing the best service you can all contribute to building trust and maintaining those long-term client relationships we all desire. That's it for today's show, and if you're looking for ways to stay in touch with commercial cleaning prospects, check out cleaningbizappointments.com. I'm Jean Hansen, and I'd love to connect with you on Facebook, LinkedIn, and Twitter. Just look for the links at cleaningbiz.tv. See you next time.